wish you one. Look twice and love will pass you by.
Like a river.
Just like a river, gotta flow to the sea. You can be sure when you look in my eyes.
Here is my song. Here is my song.
Take what you want.
Take what you
baby,
want.
Don't ever let go.
Everything that I do, yeah, I do it for the love of you.
Here is my song.
Baby, baby,
here is my song.
Your love.
Take what you want.
Take what you want.
Check. All right, good evening, everyone. Good evening, good evening. Peace and blessings. Merry Christmas. Happy Kwanzaa, Bagani, Happy Hanukkah, Happy New Year to everybody. Thank you all for tuning in, listening. Tuned in to the Success Scholar. I'm here on elifemedia.net. I'm here each and every Monday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and it's a beautiful, beautiful day. No snow, no rain, no frigid weathers, and no frigid rain, and no ice rain. So that's always a good thing. So for you all at home, you can tune in to elifemedia.net on the website. And if you are on your mobile app, of course, you can listen each and every Monday on the Ustream. Upload the Ustream app. So a lot of good things are going on. I am Haki Ami, the Success Scholar here, best-selling author, speaker, coach, and business builder, you know, job career development in the area of job career development, life development. So, you know, a lot of good, phenomenal things are going to be going on over the next few weeks. I mean, it's just been an awesome, awesome year. And you can check out some of my previous shows. And just want to thank Brother Roland for his amazing show that he just did. Brother Roland Grimes is going to be producing here, engineering, and I have a good sister that's going to be calling in any minute. So get ready for that. Get ready for that. But a lot of transformational, empowering things are going to be going on, and I'm you know, I can't announce everything, but you know, it's going to be some game changing operations. I may say a little bit towards the end after I get my good sister in, but so I'm just definitely looking forward to that. So let me try to see if she's out there. I'm gonna try to get my sister in. She'll be calling in any minute. But hope everybody got a chance to, you know, spend time with your family, however, wherever you do what you do. And you know, hopefully it was peaceful. You know how sometimes we Brother Roland folk get together on the holidays. It's not, you know, always the most.
And all the pent up things they held all year long just happened to come out. Like when that eggnog kick in, right?
Yeah, right, right. Yeah, yeah, man. How was your holidays, Brother Roland?
It was wonderful, man. I had a tremendous experience. My mother, mm-hmm, at 75 years old, had an opportunity to have all but two of her grandchildren seated around her for Christmas Eve. Man, it was special. One of her grandchildren is at a bowl game, actually, in Detroit today, the University of Maryland. They lost, but she's on the athletic training staff, so she couldn't make it.
Okay.
But I got a picture with mom and all of her grands. And do you know, I guess the best gift sometimes is each other. Keep it at that, brother.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. Well, I was doing some city life saving duties all day and all night yesterday. So, fortunately, Baltimore is still there. So, nothing crazy, but we're close to the end of the year. You know, Baltimore is coming up on, you know, well, surpassed 300, you know, homicides in the city. But, you know, I'm a part of the movement for transformation. And so hopefully I can position and reposition myself to be in a position to offer some levels of encouragement to individuals that I come across. So I'm just waiting for this amazing, amazing sister who's going to be chiming in any minute. If Ari, if you're out there, you definitely can go ahead and call in now. But before I do, yeah, I got my good sister. I was looking through the this is a film rolling that we did. This is based upon Black firefighters. Before I do, and we did a red carpet premiere. Actually, did some premieres. I went and saw it in New York. Kim Connor. Shout out to Sister Kim. So I was going to speak about some movies as well today, but hopefully we'll have Sister Ari calling in. But this is a film, y'all. Before I do, go to Before I Do. Let me see what this site is. Before I Do the film.com. Or Google Before I Do Film, the movie. Make sure you do that. Check out this independent Black film. We, you know, encouraging people to check it out. So lots of amazing things going on, but this coming Friday, as we've been doing in the Baltimore area, is at the Vulcan Blazers hand dance, I shall say. So for those that are, you know, so inclined, each and every Friday at the Vulcan Blazers in Baltimore, you know, encouraging everybody to check that out. Just had a good time there, you know, the past couple weekends, past couple Fridays, if you will. You know, I wasn't there every Friday, but, you know, every chance I kind of slide through for a couple minutes and see, you know, support the Vulcan Blazers in Baltimore, the African-American firefighters. So with that being said, as well as karaoke and things like that, so, you know, a lot of good things going to be coming up here. I'm looking forward to, you know, really presenting more formally, and hopefully, I'm not sure what's going on. Anything happening here at Vulcan Blade? I'm sorry, at the E-Life Brother Roland? No, you got something dropping.
Yeah, we're moving forward into the new year. We're going to create those press passes, man, so that we can have access to, you know, pretty much anything.
You'll have your press pass.
Hopefully by the end of January, we'll have those printed. Okay. And we'll start asking for press credentials for main events, major events.
Nice.
And it'll be accessible to everyone on your team. And in addition to that, this is the year that we now take the next step in terms of marketing the station itself.
Okay. All right.
So we're going to develop some capital, move some capital in order to be in a position by the end of the year to have those billboards up and to have that kind of presence in a street team to really market this this station. However, I do have great news. When I go back and I look at the analytics just off of our YouTube transmissions, we've had viewership from persons in 181 countries.
181 countries.
181 all right. countries and all 50 states. And the amazing thing, Brother Haki, is that, and I told the group earlier, is that 75% of our viewers, guess what gender?
Guess what gender? Females. What?
Yeah, it would seem like it would be females.
Oh, really? They males?
Male.
Interesting. Okay.
Now, I've never seen that.
Oh, really?
And all the time that I've studied this business, I've never seen anything other than 30 years ago when sports was, you know, football especially, was pretty much a male thing. But now that's even changed. But where males are three quarters of the viewership and listenership, that says a lot, because typically males are the last to tune into the kind of information and the kind of things that we do on a station like this.
Interesting. Okay. All right. Why do you think that is, bro?
It's a great question. And right now, what I think, and I told someone earlier, men, especially African-American men, have found a home here.
Okay.
They found a place of expression. even among the women, that because you know most of the shows are done by women here.
Right.
Okay. That black men have found a place of expression that includes them in ways that they don't find on any almost any other network out there, including black networks. When you look at the demographic information of any network, whether it's a major black station, whether it's BET, whether it's OWN, KYS, what you're going to find a predominance of female listenership when you're talking about things that have some kind of intellectual fiber to it.
Right.
So this is an anomaly.
Wow, that's really interesting. Yeah. That's interesting. Yeah, I'm always sometimes check out my YouTube analytics, and you can see some of those different things. And you know, so and my guest is going to be calling in any minute now. So I'm looking forward. We have our sister, and I have her actual push planner, Sister ARI. Squire, she has been on here before.
Push planner.
Yeah, for 2000. What's this? 2016,
I've never seen that before. Can you explain what that is, bro?
Well, I'll let her. Kind of come on in. She's going to talk about it. But, you know, for you all that don't know, I'm Haki Amid, a success scholar, bestselling author of Mission Unstoppable, Extraordinary Stories of Failure.
Great book. Blessing. You have a phone call. And,
yeah, so I guess that's my guess. So definitely, you all go to my website, Success Scholar. HAKI.com to check that out. So, so I have my wonderful guest that has just chimed in. So, let me welcome to eLife back to eLife Media, Sister ARI Squires. Welcome.
Hello, welcome. Thank you so much for having me.
All right. Yeah. See, you've been continuing to build the process here. So let's let everybody know this wonderful Sister ARI Squires, multi-author, multi-talented author, business extraordinaire, has been doing some tremendous work. Has been doing some tremendous work within the DMV area and all over. She's been traveling, teaching and empowering women and men and everybody else, but definitely she's been a real positive voice for transformation. She has several books. She has a push planner that I just showed to the listening audience, and she has been working as well on a film. So how have you been, Sister ARI? How's everything?
Everything is really good, Haki. I have been busy. I have been very busy, but it's been a really good busy. Whenever you're helping people transform their lives and tap into their greatness and help them bring that out, it's always just a beautiful thing, So I have no complaints.
Right. So how many books you have now? And I think you have a new one, correct?
I do. I have two new books that actually, we already launched, is called The No More Chains. It's a book anthology.
Okay.
And that book is what inspired the film, or vice versa.
Okay.
So it's called No More Chains. So it's a book anthology with 11 other powerful women entrepreneurs who have succeeded against the odds, sharing their story. Wow. And then I'm releasing a book the early part of January called Release That Book and Get Paid. And that's
right.
A book where, yes, I'm teaching entrepreneurs or anyone who wants to share their story, you know, how to share their story and make money, you know, and sell the book and create, you know, a brand and leverage the book for.
Yes, absolutely, Sister ARI. And, you know, just thinking about, you know, the power of having a book, you know, I know what it has done for me. And, you know, sometimes when you're out there, you're trying to build your business and you're doing everything you can. Can you share, for instance, your experiences when you first came out with your first book, and, you know, comparatively, if what you thought would have happened if you didn't have a book, for you or even one of your clients or that you observed as one of their testimonies?
Okay, say that question one more time. What was the question?
Yeah, so what I'm saying is how you, for instance, when you first published your book, like, we experience authors, for instance, or speakers or individuals in business may have challenges, and they may not understand the role or the value, first and foremost, of having a book, even before they even think about selling it. So for the ladies within this book, would you say they were already ready? For the anthology, were they already ready? And or did they have to be encouraged to say, this is why you need to write a book?
I think it was a little bit of both. Okay. All the women that are in this book anthology, all of the authors, only one is a previous author, but they all wanted to share their story. And so it was something that they kind of had to, you know, reflect in their own journey and really tap into their own reason, you know, for wanting to share their story. Now, of course, I went through some writing coaching with them. You know, I coached them on the process. You know, I found out what their story was, and we came up with what the message would be. Because whenever you share your story, yes, we can share our story, but we usually want to share it so we can inspire people in some kind of way. You know, we want to share it for a reason, you know. And so for me, mine was because I just wanted to put it all out there. I wanted, you know, people to know that no matter what you've been through, you can succeed against the odds, and we don't have to stand, you know, behind our story. We can stand in front of our story and create change and create a successful life and business from it. So it's kind of like monetizing from your message, you know, so to speak. Mm.
Wow. Let me shout out one of the sisters whom I know, Sister Tiffany.
Yes,
yeah.
Leslie.
Yes, say a little bit about her so I can send this to her and say, we talked about you, girl.
But you know, Tiffany. Well, Tiffany is a, and I don't want to, you know, I don't. Her story, you know, you have to read the.
Yeah, you don't have to give all of it out, right?
Right, but Tiffany is the first Black captain in the Alexandria Fire Department.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And she had to overcome so many things because, as a Black woman fire chief, she, you know, it's, you don't see many of them.
Right,
you know,
yes.
It's mostly, you know, white male dominated. So she had to, you know, break through a lot of chains to get to where she is today. And her story is one of courage, perseverance, consistency, you know, prayer, faith, all of that.
Mm-hmm.
And her story is very, very inspiring. And, you know, and recording her for the film, I had a challenge with her story in particular because, you know, most people in the story have had, like, these struggles of parent neglect, incarceration, homelessness, HIV diagnosis. Where her, she had a pretty normal childhood. You know, she had a pretty normal upbringing. Mm-hmm. Nothing devastating, nothing dramatic that she really had to overcome in her childhood.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, you know what? Everybody doesn't have to have a negative story in order to, you know, tell it or for other people to be inspired by it.
Right.
So what we did with her, we shared that, you know, we used her story and her upbringing and the way her parents raised her as an example, you know, of how we as, you know, Black families, you know, should be raising our children, you know, loving them, nurturing them, you know, giving them the freedom to dream, you know, that kind of thing. So I love her story. You can definitely read it in the
absolutely. And we'll certainly give out the website for those that would like, and certainly I definitely want to get when your book on speaking, you know, definitely got that copy coming for me.
Absolutely.
So, and Sylvia loves your push planner, so I have it here, so to show everybody, and she uses it. And she told me to bring it back.
Oh, good. So. Yes. Well, the 2017 push planner, is or order right now.
Okay.
We're going to be shipping the next week. We had an issue with our printer, but we will be shipping them next week. We're so excited, so excited. It's a wonderful plan for entrepreneurs who want to be productive and profitable in their business. So I'm glad that she likes it.
Mm, yes. And so, and your publishing company is SheEo. So just to let everybody know, and so you do ghostwriting company committed to creating polished and rich content books, planners, and journals from a variety of inputs led by dedicated editorial and creative design teams that bring great ideas and stories to life. All right. So that's SheEo Publishing, and we'll give out more of her information as well. So, and you coach clients to have their work seen well beyond their local reach into several media outlets. So, you went, let's see, I don't know if I was trying to get you to go somewhere or we were talking about doing something, but you had to go to Miami for that. What was going on, Ari? When was that?
The American Black Film Festival.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So what was going on with down there? I don't think we talked about it last time you were on. So how did you experience?
Wow, it was truly amazing. I went to the film festival to see what the film festival was all about because I was in the process of writing, you know, the treatment for my movie No More Change. So I wanted to see, because I want my film to be a success, and you know, I want to know, you know, we got to study, you know, wherever we want to be. So I went there to do some research, and I met some incredible filmmakers, I met some incredible producers, actors and directors and TV executives, you know, major studios from Hollywood to BET. It was just amazing. It was a wonderful experience, great learning experience.
Wow, yeah, that Miami area has some pretty good happenings, right? That's, you know, that's some good stuff going on down there. So what else has been going on? And you had your conference a couple months ago?
Yes, I did my conference. I do an annual Release the Chains conference for visionary women in business. And so it was phenomenal. We did it there in Falls Church, Virginia. It's an annual conference that we do each year for, you know, women who are just interested in, you know, elevating, you know, taking their vision and creating, making it into a reality. So we educate them. You know, it's not a whole bunch of empowerment and inspiration. It's more, let's work, you know, let's learn the tools, let's get some strategies, you know, let's invest in ourselves to take things to the next level so we can really, you know, get the help and assistance we need. So it was great. It was really good. Mm-hmm. So my next one that I'm doing is I'm doing the Release the Chains Revenue Retreat. Mm-hmm. And so we're going to focus more on our mindset, our spirituality, and our business. So it's going to be great, and we're doing that one in Aruba.
Oh, really? Oh. Is this your first time going there? You hear that, bro? Sister going to Aruba.
Yes, it's going to be my first time.
Okay. I mean, so, but have you done the retreats like this or before?
No.
Okay.
I am going to be taking my clients. The clients that I work with, we're going to Puerto Rico in February, so that'll be like my first time doing like a business retreat per se.
Right.
So
right.
That's coming up in February 2017.
Wow, beautiful. So, yeah, that brother Roland, going to Puerto Rico, taking some of her clients to Puerto Rico, and you know, sometimes you have to do that. You know, you have to take people out of that normal comfort zone. I've gone to several different conferences and they've shared that you can't work with somebody. Most of the major speakers, teachers and coaches, they all say that they can't do something within a particular environment, you know, where people can go home and get their normal you know, their normal routine, feel the same way, talking to the same people, and that's the power, like you said. I mean, so is that your intent
to doing that, to kind of get people out of their normal routine, get their mind right?
That is absolutely true. That is absolutely true, because you have to be, whenever I go to conferences, like whether it's LA or New York, I always make sure that I stay at the venue where the conference is, so I can meet and network and I make sure that I have everything, you know, taken care of. My husband, he has food, my child, he's taken care of, so I don't have to worry about, you know, what's going on. So I want to take people, and I want us to really connect with, you know, each other. You know, and I want us to bond. And I want us to really get into a creative process as we work on our business. And I think the best way to do that, like you said, is to get away from the normal hustle and bustle.
Yeah, so, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, this is the ARI SQUIRES author, and now... Film director or writer? What's your title with that, sis?
Film producer.
She produced the No More Chains film, as well as the book that's going to be coming out. I'm sorry. So wait a minute. What's already out, ARI? Let me get everything clear.
Okay, the book right now is out. The book is out.
Okay.
You can get the book on nomorechainsfilm.com. And the film will be out. The first screening will come February 18th, 2017.
Oh, wow. Okay. So where are you going to be screening that at there?
The first screening we have locked in as of today is in Fredericksburg, Virginia. And then we'll be doing Sacramento, California, March.
Back to your hometown, right? Shout out Sacramento, West Coast. Right. Go ahead.
So and then, we'll be doing New York, D.C., Atlanta, and all the major cities.
All right. That's cool. Yeah, it sounds good. I'm very proud of ARI. She's always grinding, always making moves, and, you know, I just certainly applaud her. I always encourage her to continue, because I see great things, you know, happening, and she's very, very well-rounded, you know, in many different aspects of her life, and not many... speakers are, you know, have these unique qualities, Brother Roland. You know, coaches have these unique qualities where they can kind of move through different kind of flows, right? you can kind of go into different places, and that's, you know, part of your background. And you know, and how's that $1 million client? Let me ask about the money.
Oh yes, absolutely. I'm still working with them. I have a 6-month contract with them, and it's everything is pretty quiet with them. Well, not quiet, but confidential. I've signed a confidentiality agreement.
Right.
But they are a entertainment company.
Okay.
Entertainment tech company, and so they have created this product that the patent is just about done. And they're already doing $2 million in sales, and so they were looking for ways to tap into the African American community, women in particular, and market their product and their services. And so they hired me, very nice check to come on board as their business coach and consultant. And so I've been working with them for the last 3 or 4 months. See, July, August. About 4 months. I have about 2 months more on the contract, but I definitely see that we'll need more, so I'm going to be offering them another 6 months because I think they need it.
Okay. All right. Beautiful. That sounds good. And, you know, and that just shows your diversity in terms of being able to, like, when you shared previously, you said you didn't, and I don't know if I'm paraphrasing you, but You didn't know if you were ready to work with a $1 million client.
That's correct. Yeah, that's correct.
But you were ready. You know, I mean, it was just your time to say, you know, I mean, a dollar, when you have the knowledge about a particular area and you start coming into meeting people, it's like, you know, that builds your confidence, and you've been definitely, you know, on different levels. So when you say a dollar amount, it's just like, yeah, that ain't no big thing. I know how to count. it just we're getting up with more, like you said, more high end clients, and that's that's what becomes important. Being able to scale up your business and know that, you know, you can't keep chasing no $5 people.
right.
Very true. And you know, you gotta show up and like George Frazier say, he said, show up like you belong places. like you belong. Like this is cool. I'm supposed to be here.
There you go. And that's the mindset that you have to have, because even though I had that quick moment of, you know, fear of, well, you know, how can I help a $1 million company, you know, make more millions when I haven't made my first million yet? Mm-hmm. You know, that was my thinking. Mm. And I said, well, you know what? Okay, I'm on my way to making yes. you know, millions in my company, but I have the knowledge, I have the research, I have the experience, yes, you know, yes, so yes. I have, and they noticed it right away. That's wow. why they invited me back, you know, to Orlando to come and have that meeting with them and their attorneys and their team, because they saw it right away just off of one wow. tip I gave them. They said that one
wow.
tip, that one strategy that I give to my clients that, you know, now, and they just said just that one thing, and they said, this is the lady we need on our team, so mm. we have to, like you say, we have to show up like we belong. And I went to that meeting confident, you know, I had everything in order, I was well prepared, you know, and they wrote that check, and I joined their team, and it's been a great experience, because I've been learning from them just as they've been learning from me, so it's been great. Wow, great.
Beautiful. Yes. So you all hear that? So she was on her way to making millions, but she was able, you know, because they respected her knowledge. And that's what I always say. I'm like, look, I know that sometimes we feel that people who are multi-millionaires or so, that somehow that they have some unique power, you know, you know, over us, but, you know, or over individuals who may not, you know, have made that much, but it's just a number. I mean, knowledge, mm-hmm. knowledge is, you know, you can't put a definitive, you know, quantitative value on an individual's knowledge and their potential and what they can bring to your team. And that's why I always say that sometimes is good, because all right, they could have dismissed you. You feel me? They could have been like, well, how many people, you know, just have you already coached, or, you know, or how many people? But every circumstance is going to be unique. You know, every mm-hmm. individual situation is going to be unique to their particular business or what they doing. So. And
there
that's
you go.
Why.
And what I found interesting, Haki, was they never even asked me that, because saw that I had the solution to their problem, and that's
right.
all they cared about.
Right.
They didn't care how much it cost.
Right.
They didn't care that I was once, you know, incarcerated.
Yes,
they didn't
yes.
care if I was black or woman. They didn't care.
Yes,
all
yes,
they
yes.
cared about was that I had the solution to their problem, that
mm.
I could help them,
right.
you know, make more money in their business. And so,
right,
you know,
right,
we get
right.
too caught up in, you know, and all the other stuff. And as business
mm-hmm.
owners, that's all we have to focus on is having that solution to our ideal client's problem and showing
right.
them that we're the one, that we're the answer to their
Absolutely.
Prayer. That's it. And I found that very interesting.
All right. Beautiful. So let's give out your website one time, and then we're going to, you know, say some more, comment some more. So if anybody want to go to Sister ARI sites, let's put that out for the listening audience.
Okay, well, my websites are really easy. It's my first and last name, and my first name is spelled ARI. My last name is Squires, SQUIRES.com.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me. And then my publishing company website is, actually they can just go to that site and it'll take you to all three sites, but I'll just say them real fast, SheEoPublishing.com, and then of course the film is nomorechainsfilm.com. ARISquires.com. But again, if you go to ARISquires.com, there's links on there to go to everything.
Wow, beautiful, beautiful. All right, that sounds good. So definitely, everyone, get ready for the releasing the change film in Fredericksburg, Virginia. So that's going to be February the 18th, as well as the book is already out for that. And her other book is going to be coming out. So definitely for all my speakers and definitely system, you know, in the new year, maybe working with the Black Writers Guild a little more. So we'll see with that. But, you know, they have a good team and, you know, hopefully I can convince them to put some coins together to get you up there because, you know, we have to support and pay for the quality services that we ask of individual, add some unique value to the wisdom that you're offering. So, like, how do you decide, for instance? I had this question because I was getting ready, like, in January, there's a conference of some Black newspapers. It's in Fort Lauderdale. Actually, we just trying to get out of the cold, but one of the things, I mean, so every year we go get out of the freezing cold, so we take 5 or 6 days to go down to Fort Lauderdale. But I was really thinking about it, you know. It's like, I mean, after attending all these conferences and all the trainings, you know, sometimes your mind is like, you know, you have so many ideas, right? And that's what I'm experiencing. And I know what I need to implement. So I just recently made a decision, and I'm going to put it in a question form. But, you know, I made a decision. I was like, you know, I know what I really already need to know. You know, it's like, I know what I need to do. Like, it's not much I'm going to learn. You know, and I don't want to say, you know, I want to appear like, well, for this one, for this particular conference, but there's also a Tony Robbins thing going on a couple of days before that. I may just kind of do a day or two there, so we go work on that. But I recently decided, like, you know, I know where I need to put my money, you know. Mm-hmm. So do you ever, because I know you know, you're still attending conferences, and we should be lifelong learners, but you know, I know, you know, you're a pro, you know, and I know you're not like going places, like being like a regular attendee, you know. Mm-hmm. So, and that's what I'm experiencing, and I just made a decision like yesterday. I was just thinking deeply about it. I was like, I don't know what really I'm gonna learn. I can stay in Maryland and socialize. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, you know, network for a regular type of thing where it's not going to be any serious life transformational type of business knowledge. I mean, I've been to the PNC for 3-4 years, so I'm just like, not that that's the end all be all of conferences, but, you know, for, you know, all those hours, you're learning some good tools that you can implement. So I are you to the point where you discerning, like, where you go? I mean, and I know we should do things for, so, you know, fun and to help people and things like that, but are you finding yourself like saying, I can't go to that right now, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, I don't, I can't.
I actually am at that point. Like, let me tell you, I just went to a conference in Los Angeles, a Big Money Speaker with James Melinchak, and I've gone.
Oh, yes, I saw you post about that. Yes.
Yes, and I've gone to that conference before, and I have to honestly say that is the absolute best conference that I've ever been to.
What?
The reason why is because it's 4 days of pure, proven information. Like, the information, like, when I go to a conference, the way I make my decision is I don't want to go just because there's a celebrity. Like, somebody somebody made this comment today about, you know, these celebrities and these actors and actresses, you know, being featured, you know, at these conferences, and people are, you know, paying thousands to go, and it's just because they're a celebrity.
But right.
They don't have any real marketing, mm-hmm. real knowledge. They don't read. They don't, you know, there's nothing that they can really teach me.
Right,
but what's
right.
happening is just because they're celebrity, people are running to them. So for me, I don't go for conferences for that.
Mm-hmm.
I go for who is going to be there
mm-hmm.
that I personally want to connect with that I can bring some value to them and they can bring some value to me and we can form some sort of partnership.
Right.
That's the first thing I say. So sometimes I will invest a couple thousand, you know, flight, hotel, ticket, food, mm-hmm. whatever, you know, to go to a conference just to connect with someone.
Mm.
That's one thing. But what I have found, too, is depending on the conference, I'm thinking, okay, what kind of people are going to be here?
Right? Exactly.
What kind of caliber? Are these going to be some... You know,
I really have
to be careful. Like, I look at who follows them. I look at mm-hmm. all kind of stuff, you know, because a lot of people are out here, you know, fronting, you know. So I'm very careful about the conferences that I will attend.
Mm-hmm.
But what you go for, sometimes it's not the knowledge. Sometimes it's not the actual people there, but it's sometimes just being in the room. I actually
right.
went to the Big Money Speaker event in the first day there. It was a 4-day event. I only went for a day and a half.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
But I actually met someone very powerful who instantly, within a couple of days, became a business partner.
Wow.
Who instantly, it's like we've known each other before. You know what I mean? It's mm-hmm. like we had a past life together, and we instantly just clicked. And this person is Tyler Perry's media coach. This person is very well connected to Tony Robbins himself.
Wow.
And now he's on my team, and I'm on his team, and we're making money together. We're going to meet up in Las Vegas with my husband next month, and
mm-hmm.
you know, and just, you know, so sometimes you just never know. So you
yes.
just pay attention to
yes.
who's going to be at this
yes.
type of conference
mm-hmm.
that I think would I can benefit and I can benefit from.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But right. I just don't go to any old conference, especially mm-hmm. a lot of these women empowerment conferences. I don't do that.
Yeah, I know what you said. Sylvia said the same thing. Yeah, yeah, absolutely, absolutely. And that's where, you know, I try to be objectively fair, you know, to
mm-hmm.
to individuals that, you know, seek my advice about different things. And I'm just like, you know, I mean, people can become like lecture junkies and, you know,
right.
and it's like a overkill when you just need to be... You need to be home working on what you do, what you can do,
yeah.
what you've learned. You know, just going back through, and I've had to learn that over time. You know, honestly, sincerely, and you're right that, you know, sometimes you do have to be like in the room to, you know, continue to build your brand. But
mm-hmm.
after a while, it's like, look, I mean, you know, like, and I take it from. You know, I just say like my streets, you know, the street experience. Like
mm-hmm.
I can't be rolling like
right.
with some people no more. you know, and you know, and things gotta happen. You know, there needs to be growth. So like what I did recently, Ari, you know, and I tell people getting some knowledge is just so. You know, it's not, you know, we live in a technologically advanced society where information is at our access. It's like information overload on some level. But I got some some audio books off of Amazon for like $1, $2. Networking with millionaires, selling to the affluent,
mm-hmm.
marketing to the affluent, you know,
mm-hmm.
just really knowing that, okay, I've done just about all I can on some levels, you know. It's like, okay, you know, time to reinvent and scale up, you know, or I heard the term level up before.
Yeah,
you gotta level up.
Yep, you gotta start implementing all of that strategies and everything that you've learned and really just start, you know, creating your own hype and your own destiny in your own tribe, in your own community, so they're coming
mm-hmm.
out to hear you speak and coming to your events and your conferences or whatever it is that you, you know, your lectures and things like that, because you, what I know about you personally,
mm-hmm.
is that you have a lot of knowledge to share and you have a great following.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm sure you're in the process now of planning, like you say, your next mood, you know, the next phase of your career. And we got to do that, and we should always be doing that constantly, you know, constantly. Right. So kudos. But I do that all the time. I'm at a point in my life where, yeah, I feel like I may not be getting the press. I may not be getting the acknowledgement. And I understand, too, that sometimes people don't want you in their space because you're a threat. And I don't care, but I do know that that's a part of it. But I know that, you know, the experience that I have and what I've been able to do for my clients far exceeds, you know, what so many others are doing, not to compare, not to say that I'm better. But it comes a time where you just say, okay, let me start, you know, working on me and keep elevating what I'm doing and my brand and my empire versus, you know, supporting everybody else.
Right. Absolutely. Talking to Sister ARI Squires. Now, the quick question in terms of, you know, I know your client base has been women on some levels, but like or black women, have you had the opportunity to expand, you know, to a degree where, because I realized that, you know, eventually, I mean, you know, when you just become so big, you know, people from different ethnic groups, you know, they're going to gravitate towards you. I'm saying to you, I know it's going to, you know, so have you experienced a transition in terms of, because, and generally I know that we are going to work with people that we know, like, and trust within our immediate environment, but have you been working and getting business? Because I say dollars are green, and, you know, somebody want to pay you for your expertise, get that money, right?
exactly. Here's where I am, because, of course, you know, I have goals, I have dreams, I have desires, you know, and a lot of things that I'm doing now, I know I won't be doing 5 years from now. You know, I know it, because I have the vision and I'm planning, you know, every, you know, 6 months to step into a new phase in my life. That's just what I have planned, and that's the way it's been going. So I know that, you know, right now I'm very happy where I am, because my ultimate goal is to see more black families, you know, wealthy, you know, having business, supporting each other. So that is my primary focus. Mm-hmm. Have I worked with some other nationalities? Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I have two women clients that are white women, and then my clients that we spoke about earlier, my million-dollar clients, they're two white gay men, you know what I'm saying? So I have, you know, worked with other people, but primarily my ideal market at this point in time, like today, right now, is the African American family, because I really sincerely, you know, advocate for, you know, black people being more successful in business, and I stand in that, even when I had my dance and performing arts school, I stood in it being a black owned dance school for black children, you know what I'm saying, like, because I wanted to provide a place, you know, for them. So I kind of stand in that, but with the film and where I'm going with the filmmaking and all of that, it is going to expand. You know, like, I see it, we're planning for it, we have a strategy for it. So yes, things will be, you know, changing slowly, but my base, my foundation, you know, will always be the African American community.
Yes, agree. Yeah, that's a good point. And We can't lose sight of you know, that bringing our people up to a certain level, and you know, because right now, actually, and the reason that I answered that, because, you know, I saw a post where they were talking about how undervalued, for instance, black talent is and black skill set, where other groups, you know, ethnic groups, for instance, simply do not support black people in commerce and trade. It's like it's a thin line, and that's where I, you know, always suggest to people, you know, don't chase dollars. I mean, I know you posted something about that, but what I mean by that, when you are just so good, you know, when you're just so good at what you do, and I mean, of course, you got to get out here and share it, you know, with people that want to, you know, that have that, that level of respect for you.
Right.
You know, money, I sincerely believe that money is going to eventually come once you got it out there to enough people, you know, and it's a numbers game. It's not just numbers, it's quality people, mm-hmm. not just, you know, necessarily quantity. And I always try to think about that. I'm like, look,
yeah.
you know, and that's where developing that level of confidence where, you know, like I told a sister in New York, and I'll let you say something. When we were talking about having Dr. George Frazier come to New York, we were worrying about how many people we gonna get, or will George come if we have these many people? And I'm like, mm-hmm. I'm like, get Oprah here. Here come. I'm like, don't, you know, I mean, I ain't, you know, putting it out there like we gotta have Oprah, but I'm just saying, like, we gotta start thinking, like, you know, I mean, not to compare and contrast ourselves with anybody, but like, yeah, yeah, like, yeah, all right, yeah, he should come for me. You know, like, he's come, mm-hmm. you know, and I understand. And sometimes, for me, I had to learn how to, you know, you got to look at your age set as well. Sometimes older people may not want you to, you know, a young person coming up, so you just target your peers.
That's true.
So that's just true. Keep it like that. They think they know everything, and you know, let them keep on and...
and do their thing. Well, my focus now with the business realm, and you know, you talk about, you know, money is green, and you know, tapping into the white community and white organizations and white companies is where we're at now, with planning to get investors, you know, people. Mm. Because what I've found out is, as I'm seeking pledges for my No More Chains movement, that I'm getting, you know, white people on board to support a black film. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So when I was talking to my attorney about this, you know, my attorney was saying, well, what's crazy is that white companies, you know, they have money allocated to support minority-based businesses, you know, and so we're tapping into, you know, those avenues, and, you know, them, you know, wanting to, you know, drop some money, either it be donations, whether it be pledges, or whether it be, you know, coming on as partners. And that's what, you know, white organizations do. They put their money into businesses and just let the money make money for them, mm-hmm. you know?
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we're tapping into now.
So,
you know, you just gotta, like I say, you just always have to elevate. You always got to have a plan for your next level. You can't, what I'm doing right now, I won't be doing this 2 years from now. Like, I know it.
Right,
I'm
right.
Every single yes. day. You know?
That's right.
That's so important, and that's what I teach people how to do. Okay, let's plan for, you know, whatever your vision is, whatever it is. We can't get there tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Right? We're not going to get there tomorrow, but let's see what we can do over the next 6 months. And then the next six months, until we get there, you know. But you've got to have the plan for elevating and tapping into more affluent markets.
Mm-hmm.
That's a necessity, whether it's black, whether it's white, whether it's, you know, Jewish, whoever.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you got to be able to be multidimensional.
The plan is to go to Wall Street, to Silicon Valley, Hollywood, you know what I'm saying? Like everywhere that where there's large scale
money
people. And I always tell people, you know, sometimes you gotta, you know, you may have to leave your little town wherever you know.
Absolutely.
you gotta know. Not every, I mean, I know people have that acres of diamond thing going on where they think that you can find diamonds in your hills of Biloxi, Mississippi, but you know, sometimes, you know, you got to go to these major, you know, hubs, international hubs, where, you know, international investors and money people are actually at. So you know, we gotta understand that, we, you know, and get into the international games, you know, like Reginald F. Lewis type stuff, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So
outside the box. That's why it's important to surround yourself with people like you, people who don't think mediocre, who really think outside of the box. And that's why going back to the conferences and the places that you go, you know, to seek knowledge or be around, you know, do your due diligence, do your research. You know, if I see an event, somebody invited me to something, I research. Who else is going?
Mm-hmm.
Is this going to be beneficial for me to go? You know, going just to be around people who are popular or these popular circles, because a lot of these popular folks, you know, are broke and don't have any real influence, you know. So you just have to be careful, and that's what I want my, you know, my brothers and sisters to know is you know, just do your research, you know, plan, plot, strategize.
That's right.
You know,
have some goals,
you know.
Absolutely.
And think outside the box, like you were saying. It's so important to think outside the box and expand your horizons and expand your circles.
Absolutely, absolutely. Okay, all right, sister. All right, so let's give out your website one more time and any, you know, closing remarks that you have, anything coming up that you want to share to our listening audience.
The only thing I have really is, you know, you can follow me at ARI Squire Speaks all across social media. I'm very active and on Instagram and social media, and I love to meet new people. I love to support Black businesses. I'm always supporting Black businesses constantly, every single day.
Right, absolutely.
And, you know, we have the No More Chains film dropping in February. It's a really big project. It's a very highly inspirational film for families. Everybody will be able to tap into one of these stories and relate to one of these stories. And I really, truly believe that every single person that walks into that theater will not leave the same. So as we're promoting, please help us share. It doesn't hurt to hit that share button. It just doesn't hurt.
Absolutely.
To hit the share button.
Right.
We need support, and we appreciate it. And you can check out some clips at NoMoreChainsFilm.com. And I appreciate you for having me on, Hachi. I really, really appreciate it. And I'll get you that planner as well. I'll get you that planner.
Oh, we this one 2016-2017. Oh, you mean the next one?
Oh, you have the 2016. Okay, good. So you're good then. Okay.
Yeah, this is the both of them.
Okay.
16 and 17. So yeah, I was I'm ready ahead of time. So like.
Okay. Good.
Oh boy. Yeah. So I want to thank you again for tuning in and chiming in with us, sister. So you keep on pushing. Looking forward to your new book coming up, and looking forward to the film, so hopefully I can make it down there on that day. Me and Sylvia are going to make it. All right.
Okay, I appreciate you. Thank you so much. Have a good night.
All right, sister. You too. Thank you. All right, brothers and sisters. Thank you all. So I was joined by my sister, a good sister, a powerful sister, ARI Squires. She's doing some amazing things. This is her push planner, 2016-2017, but she has one with 2017 coming out. This is Haki Ameed, the Success Scholar. My man, Roland Grimes holding it down. He had a good relationship show a little earlier. Man, I'm like, man, these women calling in these radio shows, like, talking about relationships, bro. They going to get you, Roland.
I'm 6'3", so make sure my coffin is at least 6'4".
Right. All right, brothers and sisters, thank you all for tuning in. E-Life Media each and every Monday, 8 to 9 p.m. elifemedia.net on the website, and as well as on a Ustream app. And share this with your friends and family. We dropping it. Support E-Life Media. Donate to E-Life Media. Advertise with E-Life Media. You know, we got some amazing program, as well as we're still looking for hosts for those that want their shows. It's happening here at elifemedia.net. Peace.
Just can't let you go, girl. Heavenly, got distracted. Oh.